Hey, Cameron McKenzie here at CameronMCNZ on Twitter, and I want to talk to you a little bit about logging inside UiPath with a big shout out to the Canadian beachcombers there. So here's my if-then-else number picker application. I built it in a previous tutorial. It only took 5 minutes to do it, so watch that tutorial if you want to see this whole thing from scratch. But it's a fairly straightforward application, and as you can see when I run it, it just kind of says, gives me a little, hey, pick a number between 1 and 10. Tells me to guess higher if I'm too low, tells me lower if I'm too high, and then if I click the right number, it says, you guessed it, it was 5, and thanks for playing. So that's the basic program there, but I thought I'd add some logging to it. And I guess I got 3 conditions here, which I could probably use the log in and demonstrate different logging levels. So to do some loggings, you hit the Activities tab, and then right under Programming, Debug, you'll notice there's this log message option. So all you have to do is drag that over into the spot where you want to do some logging. Here I've got the message box that says guess higher, and I'll set the log level. Notice there's 5 levels. I'm going to use 3 here, error, warn, and info. But I'll do an info message here, and I'll just say informing them to guess higher. And then similarly here, when they guess lower, we can add another log message over here. And in this case, why don't we do it as warned? Yeah, that's fantastic. And then finally, right before our break over here, because we actually got an infinite loop, it's kind of funny, we got to use an infinite loop. See, that's a do while loop. And by setting the condition to true, we made it infinite. But we did put a break in here to exit out if somebody figures out what the correct number is. So why don't we log over here? And sure, why don't we even make that the error log warn, error log level. And there we go. You know, I mean, this isn't really an error. I mean, it doesn't really justify an error, but, you know, we're just demonstrating how these logs work. Okay, so and that's how easy it is to add, you know, info, warn, error. And when you actually run your file, you notice if you come back into UiPath, I'm going to select a number. So I'll select one that's too low. It'll say guess higher. And you'll notice that down in the bottom left-hand corner, it says informing them to guess higher. So that's the logging that happened right there. We'll guess too high, it'll say guess lower. And now you notice that it comes in as orange when we've got that warning type of level, so warning them to guess higher. And you notice it even keeps track here with a number of warnings, number of information, number of error. Why don't we hit the nail on the head? There's number 5. It says you guessed it was 5. And then that's when our error log comes out. And you can see it is in the very punitive red right there. Exiting isn't really an error. And so that maps to all the different log elements that we had on our page. You can even come over here, and I think if you want, you can actually save that log file to an output and then process it if you want to take a deeper look at some of the things that may have been logged into that log file. And there you go, that's the basics of logging.